Cita saya cik tong sing mo tau. Please say a silent prayer. Doa dalam hati. Amen. 在我们今天的下午聚会之前，让我们大家一起来同心祷告. Sebelum kebaktian petang ini, sila sama-sama sujud berdoa. Before the afternoon service, let us all kneel down and pray together. 让我们来一同唱诗赞美神。Marilah kita naikkan pujian kepada Tuhan. Let us all sing hymn to praise God. Sing hymn number 62. 唱诗第六十二首。Kidung 62。63. 唱下一首诗63首 Kidung seterusnya 63. Thank you. The next hymn, hymn number 64. 唱下一首诗, 第64首, 기동 seterusnya, 64. First stanza. 65, 来唱下一首诗第65首, 기동 seterusnya 65. First stanza. 61, 唱下一首诗第61首, 기동 seterusnya 61. First stanza. Sesung tau ci, thank God our hymnal session ends here. Syukur kepada Tuhan, kidong sesi kidong sampai di sini. Haleluya.
可以开始哈。哎，哈利路亚！各位主亲爱的、所拣选的、我们将来被天使点名的，大家安息日平安。
Hallelujah, dear brothers and whom the Lord Jesus loves and has chosen, and whose names will be marked by the angels. Peace be with you.
我们现在预备一个清洁的心，来继续的聚会。 继续的敬拜主耶稣，我们天上独一的真神。
Let's continue to prepare a pure heart, a holy heart to continue to worship our true God in heaven, the Lord Jesus Christ.
同心默祷。
Say a silent prayer.
阿门。 奉主耶稣圣名，继续安息日的聚会。
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we continue with our Sabbath worship.
大家起立唱赞美诗 195首。
Let's rise to sing hymn 195.
永远永生的地方，当众颂赞。
我们祷告，求主祝福带领我们下午的聚会。
Let's pray for the blessing and the grace of the Lord Jesus in guiding us in this afternoon service.
大家同心合意，奉主耶稣圣名跪下祷告。
In one accord, in one heart, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告。哈利路亚，感谢赞美主耶稣。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，感谢主耶稣，阿们。哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名正道。
Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I speak.
靠着圣灵的帮助。
By the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们一同来分享，来勉励回家这一篇信息。
Let's share and encourage one another with this topic, going home.
我要有一个家。
I want to have a home.
一个不需要华丽的地方
，a home that does not need to be glamorous and spectacular。
在我疲倦的时候
，when I'm tired，
我会想到它
，I will think of my home。
我想要有一个家
，I want to have a home。
一个不需要多大的地方
，a home that does not need to be very big。
在我受惊吓的时候
，when I'm in shock，
我才不会害怕
，I do not fear。
有谁不会想要有个家
？Is there anyone who does not want a home？
可是就是有人没有家。
But there are people who do not have a home.
我好羡慕他呀。
And don't I admire them?
受伤的时候可以回家。
Who have a home to return to when they are injured?
虽然你有一个家。
Although you have a home.
你什么都没有缺乏。
And you don't lack anything.
那为什么却看不到你露出笑容的你？
But why am I not seeing a smiling face on you?
为何你整天不回家？
And why don't you return home?
回家对许多人来说是一件再平凡不过的一件事。
Going home is something that is so ordinary to many people.
可是对于一些人来说，却是那么样的困难，是那么样的奢望的。
And yet, to some people, it is such a difficult and almost an impossible wish.
有一次临近新年的时候，传道在医院探访。
During a Chinese New Year, I was visiting a hospital.
在医院，我听到一个生病的孩子这样的对他的爸爸说。
There was a sickly young boy.Who was saying this to his father?
爸爸，我什么都不要。
Father, I do not want anything.
我只想要回家。
I just want to go home.
一句这么简单的一句话。
Such a simple phrase.
却是这个孩子留下最后的一句话。
Happened to be the last phrase that this boy ever uttered in his life.
他最后对父亲说的话就是：爸爸，我什么都不想要。
That was his last words before he passed on.Father, I do not want anything.
我只是想要回家。
I just want to go home.
他永远回不到家。
But he never returned home.
这是我在探访医院中遇到一个很痛心、很悲伤的事情。
That was one of the most saddening things that I met when I visited the hospital.
这个场景常常在我的内心深处的浮现出来。
And this scenario kept coming back to my mind very often.
然后常常的告诉自己，原来。可以回家，并不是那样的必然的，不是的。
Then I told myself that it is not something very natural for people to be able to return home.
你看，有些人想要回家，却回不了家。
Look, there are people who want to go home, but they can't go home.
就像刚才那个想回家的孩子，他回不了。
Just like this sickly boy that I talked about just now.
那有些人想回家，可是却没有家让他回。
There are some people who want to go home, but there's no home for them to return to.
有些人有家，但是他却天天不回家。
There are people who have a home, but they do not want to go home.
感谢真神的赐福。
We thank our Father, our true God.
让我们大家都拥有三个幸福的家。
For His blessing that we all have a blessed home.
三个幸福的家。
Three blessed home.
你知道你有三个家吗
？Do you know you have three blessed homes?
这是神给我们的祝福来的。
That is a blessing from God to us.
第一个家就是我们自己的家。
The first home is our own home.
里面有我们的孩子、我们的太太、我们的父母亲、我们的家人、我们最亲的人在里面。
Our biological home, where with our immediate family, our parents, our children.
那是神给我们的自己的家。
And that is our home that God has granted to us.
第二个家是神的家。
And the second home is the home of God.
这个是一个大家庭。
This is a big household.
这个家里面有许许多多的弟兄姐妹，有各种不同的兄弟姐妹在里面。
In this big family, there are many kinds of brothers and sisters and diverse family members.
这里面有许多神的爱，有许多神的荣耀，跟有许多神的工作。
There is a lot of love and a lot of glory and a lot of work of God.
那第三个家是什么呢
？What is your third home?
第三个家就是我们将来要回去的永远的家。
Your third home is the future home that you are going to return to, the eternal home.
那个是最美丽、最荣耀、最快乐、最永恒的。
That's the most beautiful, eternal, glorious, and joyful home.
兄弟姐妹
，Dear brothers and sisters,
我们不单只有家。
Not only do you have a home,
我们还有三个这么美满、这么幸福的家。
You have three such abundant and beautiful homes.
但是你有珍惜吗
？But do you ever cherish?
你有回家吗
？Have you returned?
你有爱这个家吗
？Have you loved this home?
今天我们从圣经上来看回家这一篇道理。
From the Bible today, we'll talk about this message, going home.
到底谁要回家呢
？Who are to go home?
第一个就是主耶稣说的浪子。回家。
Firstly, the prodigal son in the parable of Jesus, he wants to go home.
浪子为什么要回家呢
？Why is the prodigal son?
什么事情使到他想要回家呢
？What causes him to want to go home?
他不是已经离开家了吗
？Didn't he already leave home?
他不是离开家越远越好吗
？Didn't he say that it is better for him to go further and further away?
甚至看他的动作、看他的表现，都打算不回家了。
And you look at his behavior, he didn't intend to ever come home.
主耶稣说。 为什么他回家。
But Jesus said that Jesus talked about the reason why he returned.
请看路加福音书十五章。
You turn to the Gospel, Luke chapter 15.
这个道理是在十一节到二十四节。
This sermon is recorded in verses 11 to 24.
这个是我们很熟悉的一个道理了。
This is a sermon that we are familiar with.
那请问什么叫做浪子？何谓浪子？
And what is this prodigal son?
简单讲，浪子就是一切以自己为中心的人，那个就是浪子。
A prodigal son is one who is self-centered.
他有自己的想法。
He has his own thinking.
他有自己的追求。
He has his own pursuits.
他要过他自己过的生活。
He wants to live a life that he desires.
而且他不受约束，也不受人，也不听劝告的。
And he is not bounded by rules, and he does not listen to any advice.
并且，他是个有家的人，但是却是不想回家的人。
And surely he has a home, but he does not want to go home.
基本上浪子就是这样子的啦。
And generally, that is what prodigal sons are like.
那他为什么要回家呢？
And why do they now want to go home?
在主耶稣讲的这篇道理当中呢，我们发现到有四个因素使他。
In a sermon by the Lord Jesus, there are four factors to lead him home.
第一个原因就是因为他已经一无所有了。
The first reason being he has nothing left.
从样样都有，堕落到一无所有。
Previously he had everything, and now he has fallen to a state where he had nothing.
我们读十四到十六节。
We read verse 14 to 16. 14. But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in the land, and he began to be in want. Verse 15. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his fields to feed swine. Verse 16. And he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pots that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything.
好，这里说他为什么要回家？
He tells us of the reason why he wants to return home.
十四节说他耗尽了，用完了一切所有的，花光了一切所有的。
Verse 14 tells us that he has spent all that he had.
如果他样样都有，请问他还想要回家吗？
If he was having everything, would he still want to come home?
我跟你讲，如果他样样都有，还有很多钱，还有很多节目，还有很多朋友，他不会想要回家的。
Let me tell you the truth that if he had everything and he had a lot of friends, a lot of money, he wouldn't think of coming home.
原来当一个人堕落到一无所有的时候，这么悲惨的地步，悲惨的生活的时候，他才想要回家。
It is only when one falls into such a desperate and a pitiful state, only then he will think of going home.
这时他才想到我还有一个家。
Only then the thought will strike him as that he still has a home.
为什么要到这样的地步才想到要回家呢？
Why would you have to come to this state before you think of going home?
怪不得有时候神在这要拿走一些，要拿走我们的一些东西。
It's no wonder that God sometimes wants to take something away from.
因为神如果不拿走这些，我们都不想回家，也没有想到要回家。
Because if God did not take away anything from you, then you would not have thought of coming home.
不过到这种地步的时候是很可怜的。
But when you come to such a state, you will become pitiful.
但是里面却有神的爱。
But even behind that, there's a love of God.
因为神要你回家。
Because God wants you to come home.
他会回家的第二个原因。
The second reason why he wants to come home.
就是在第十七节。
In verse 17.
这里说他突然间醒悟过来，他醒悟过来。
It tells us that he came to himself, he realized.
他想为什么我会落到这样悲惨的光景啊？
Why did I come to such a pitiful state?
因为十六节说他没有东西吃啊，想要吃猪吃的东西啊，不是人吃的呀。是猪吃的东西呀，人家都不给他吃呀。
Verse 16 tells us that he was so pitiful that he wanted to eat the food of the swine, and people do not want to give him.
除非他是偷偷的去偷那些猪吃的东西来吃咯。
Unless he were to steal from the swine to eat.
那是什么意思呢？
What does that mean?
那就是你在跟猪抢吃啊，抢猪吃的东西来吃呀。
You are trying to steal and snatch away the food from the swine.
我们需要过这样的生活吗？
Do you need to live such a deplorable life?
为什么今天会过这样的悲惨的生活呀？
And why have you come to live such a pitiful life?
他在思想。
He was thinking to himself.
在想的时候，十七节说他醒悟过来。
Verse 17, when he was thinking, he came to realization.
是啊，我为什么要过这样的生活？
And yes, why did I have to live such a life?
我有父亲啊。
I have a father.
我有一个家呀。
I have a home.
而且我父亲的家那边有很多很多的粮食呀。
And my father's house have a lot of food to spare.
难道我真的在这里饿死吗？
Should I perish here with hunger?
难道我这样的生活真的连猪都比不上猪的生活吗？
Is my life even not comparable to the life of a swine?
这就是一个让他能够回家的，就是他及时的反省去思想。
And the factor that drove him to return home is his immediate realization.
第三件,
the third factor.
他能够回家的第三个原因是他悔改来认错。
The third reason why he wanted to go home was that he was able to repent.
18节到19节。
Verse 18 to 19.
请念。
Verse 18, I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. 19, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.
那当他要回家的时候呢，他做了一个悔改跟认错。
When he wanted to go home, he regretted and repented.
不是回到家里才认错。
He did not only confess when he returned home.
还没有回家的时候，在思想的时候，在思考的时候，他就已经认错了。
And when before him reaching home, he was already admitting to all his faults.
他说：“我不单只得罪父亲。”
He said that not only have I sinned against my father,
我也得罪了天，得罪了神。
I have sinned against heaven and God.
我得罪神，也得罪自己的父亲。
I have sinned against God and against my father.
地上的父亲我也得罪了，天上的父亲我也得罪了。
I have sinned against my father on earth and my father in heaven.
所以十九节他觉得自己不配，他觉得他自己的罪很深呐。
Verse 19 said that he is not worthy and his sin was deep.
我就算回家，我也不配当再成为一个儿子啊。
If I were to go home, I am not worthy to be called your son.
只要我能够成为家里的佣人，在那边服侍父亲，服侍家里的一切，我就满意了，我就知足了。
All I ask for is to be your hired servant to serve you at home, and I will be satisfied.
这个是他要回家之前他已经定下的心志。定下的一个这样行动。
That was his determination that he made before he went home.
因为我觉得我不配了。
I know that I'm not worthy.
如果父亲能接纳我做一个工人，我就满足了，我就满心感谢了。
As long as my father is willing to accept me as his servant, then I am satisfied.
这个是什么
？What is this？
这个就是认错跟悔改。
This is admitting to his faults and repentance.
你如果不认错不悔改啊，你回不了家的。
If you don't admit to your sin and you don't repent, you cannot return.
如果你没有觉得自己是不配的，不配做一个儿子的，你这样大大方方的这样大摇大摆回家的，那个不是真悔改来的。
If you don't feel as though you are not worthy and you are coming home with a proudly, then you are not repenting.
你没有看到有些所谓的悔改回来教会的大小声讲话的吗？又要要求这个，又要要求那个，又要要求圣工，要要求怎样怎样的吗？还甚至在骂人，这叫做悔改吗？ Haven't, 回来教会这么大声的吗？
Haven't you seen some members coming back to church and saying that they want to repent, but they are speaking loudly and scolding people as though they were also proud.
你看这个浪子是怎样悔改？他说我不配做一个儿子了，但是我要回家。我愿意在家里做个佣人，我也满足了。
Look at how this prodigal son is repenting. He's repenting. He is not even worthy to be called the son, and he wants to be the servant. He's already satisfied.
老师说，这样的悔改认错需要极大的勇气。
This kind of repentance requires a great deal of courage.
那第四个原因让他回家的是什么呢
？What's the fourth factor to drive him home?
就是二十节
，verse 20.
于是起来往他父亲哪里去。第四个原因就是立马行动，马上行动。
He arose and came to his father. He took action.
如果他在思想
，if he was just contemplating，
他也在悔改认错。
He was also repenting.
可是他没有行动啊，他没有一种行动回家。
But he did not take any action to return home.
那你还是在外面呢、啊？你还是一个浪子呀、啊。
Then you still dwell outside as a prodigal.
因为你所谓的反省啊，你所谓的认错啊，但是你没有行动的。
Because your so-called repentance and your confession has no action.
所以能够让他回家的第四个原因是他立马行动。
The fourth factor to lead him home is that he took action.
就是我们常常讲的心动不如行动。
That's why we often say that. You are moved, but you have to move with action.
我们常常在开会，开一百次的会议，不如一次的行动。
And you have a hundred times meetings, it is not comparable to one time action.
那回家的动机跟他的基础到底是什么呢
？And what is the motivation and the foundation behind his action of going home?
这个浪子的回家的动机与基础是建立在自我的反省。
His motivation and his foundation of returning home is built upon his self-examination.
第二，再加上他认错悔改的心。
And secondly, he admitted to his wrongs and sins, and he repented.
这样还不够，还加上他立刻行动的那个行为。
That's not even everything. That he also continued to take action of repentance.
不是说一句话哦，我回来了，不是这样的。
It was not just coming home and say that I'm home.
你回家的动机跟基础是什么？
And what is your motivation and your foundation that leads you home?
是带着大摇大摆，好像父亲一定接受我的这种心回来吗？
Are you just walking in brazenly and proudly as though everyone should be accepting you?
那圣经怎么样对我们说呢？
What did the Bible say to us?
世界说是主耶稣怎么样说呢？
What did the Lord Jesus say to us?
20节，
Verse 20.
这里说，于是父亲，这里看到他父亲就看见他，父亲就看见。
His father saw him.
哦，看见了，然后就动了慈心。
And had compassion.
动了慈心，然后才跑去，
迎接他。Ran and welcomed him.
跑去过后呢，然后才抱他。
And then, embraced him.
抱他过后呢，然后才与他亲嘴啊。
And then kissed him.
父亲做的这几个动作，一切都在注意耶稣说的那句话。父亲看见。
And all this action that came along with the father was started with the father seeing him.
浪子能够成功的回家，除了蒙父亲接纳以外。
For the prodigal son to be able to successfully return home other than getting accepted by the father.
更重要的是他懂得及时悔改认错。
More importantly, he was able to promptly repent.
甚至存着不配的心来回家。
And with a heart feeling he was unworthy, he returned.
这种不配的心就是我愿意回家做一个仆人，有一个做仆人的心，愿意做仆人的心来回家。
His realization that he was unworthy, he had a heart to become the servant of his home.
这个仆人的心就是我要服侍这个家了。我要服侍这个家里面的工的人，我要做家里面一切的工作，这个叫做仆人的心。
The heart of a servant is one that is willing and very willing to do any and everything of the work in the household of God.
这一些他的父亲都看见了。
In the household of father and everything his father has seen.
圣经说的看见是不但只看见他外在的行动、外表的行动，更看见了他那一颗不配的心啊。
And not only did the father see his outward action and his works, he also saw his heart of unworthiness.
这叫做父亲看见。主耶稣要讲的就是父亲看见，外面里面都看见了。
That's what it means by the father saw. The father saw what is outside and also what is inside your heart.
浪子说：“我要回家。”
Therefore, the prodigal son says, "I want to go home."
感谢主，他成功回到了家。
We thank the Lord that he has returned.
好，我们讲第二个回家的信息。
Talk about second message about going home.
我想要回家，却回不了家。
I want to go home, but I can't.
谁想要回家，可是却回不了呢？
Who is this person who wants to go home but he can't?
每一次我翻到他的事迹的时候，看到他的时候，我会觉得很可惜，也是为他来悲伤。
And every time I refer to this passage about his story, I feel very pitiful and take pity on him, and I'm sad for him.
他回不了家，讲起来不完全是他的错的。
And for him, the fact that he couldn't return home was not his fault.
因为他确实是个忠心的工人来的。
He was indeed a faithful worker.
而且他也坚持神的话语，他也一次两次的在坚持神的话语。
He also persisted with the word of God every time.
那为什么回不了家呢？
And why couldn't he return home?
我们来看《列王记上》的十三章。
Return to 1 Kings chapter 13.
《列王记上》十三章。
1 Kings chapter 13.
我们读23到25节。
Verse 23 to 25. 23. So it was, after he had eaten bread and after he had drunk, that he saddled a donkey for him, the prophet whom he had brought back. When he was gone, a lion met him on the road and killed him, and his corpse was thrown on the road, and a donkey stood by it. The lion also stood by the corpse. 25. And there the men passed by and saw the corpse thrown on the road and the lion standing by the corpse. Then they went and told it in the city where the old prophet dwelt.
这里所记录的这件事情啊，是每一个侍奉神的工人都要非常认真去看待的事件。
This incident that's recorded here is something that all faithful workers of God today have to examine closely.
这里说有一个年轻的先知啊，被神重用，叫他到北朝伯特利那边去做圣工，去完成神的工作。
Here tells us of this young worker, this young prophet who was sent to the northern kingdom Bethel to complete the work of God.
因为这个北朝这个耶罗波安常常做让神愤怒的事情，得罪神的事，神差遣这个年轻先知去责备他。
OK, King Jeroboam of the Northern Kingdom always sinned against God and offended God, and God sent this young prophet to rebuke him.
难道北朝没有先知吗？
Wasn't there any prophet in the Northern Kingdom?
有啊，北朝也有先知啊。
There were prophets.
就是这里看到的那个老先知，就是神的先知来的呀。神用的先知来的，在北朝工作的呀。
This prophet of the Northern Kingdom was this old prophet recorded here.
但既然有老先知在那边，为什么神不用老先知，跑去用南国的年轻先知，从南国到北国来？
Why is that?
漏国文错，漏国街啊。
And therefore, now that the Northern Kingdom had their own prophets, this old prophet was there. And why did God have to send this young prophet from the Southern Kingdom to another kingdom to do this?
但是这个不是我们的重点。
This is not my point.
我也没有时间讲，再讲很多他这一段的细节了。
I have no time to elaborate to you on the details.
我要讲的就是他为什么回不了家？
I'm trying to tell you why he wasn't able to return.
因为他违背了神的命令。
Because he violated the commandment of God.
神的命令是什么呢？
What was the commandment of God?
第九节，
verse 9.
有神的话吩咐我说，第一，不可以在伯特利吃饭喝水。
The commandment of God came by the word of God. You shall not eat and drink in Bethel.
第二，不可以从来的路回去，要走别的路回去。
And you cannot return by the same way you came. You have to take another way.
神给他的命令很清楚。
The commandment of God was very clear.
简单讲起来就有两个。
There was only two.
一个，你绝对不可以在伯特利吃饭，也不可以在那边喝水，连喝水都不可以。
Simply put, you shall not eat nor drink in Bethel.
为什么不能够吃饭喝水？
Why shall you not eat and drink?
你不用问这么多，神说不可以，我们就顺服。神说不可以，那就是不可以。
Don't ask so many questions. This is the commandment of God. You shall only obey.
神这样命令我们，需要给我们理由吗？需要给我们解释吗？
Does God is God obliged to explain everything to you?
神这样告诉我们说，就是要我们服从的时候，你不用问这么多，你就是照做就对了。
And since God has commanded very clearly, you shall only obey.
你做得到吗？
Can you complete?
你为什么今天问这么多原因？为什么呢？为什么呢？讲这么多理由呢？
Why do you ask so many things and why do you question so many things today?
你讲这么多理由，问这么多理由，你到底要不要顺服的？你到底要不要照神的话做的？不要在这里吃饭，不要在这里喝水，你做得到吗？你要不要做？
You are questioning so much. You are asking for with so many excuses. And are you about to obey, or are you just going to eat and drink here?
第二件事。
Secondly,
你不可以从原来的路回去，要从另外一条路回去。
You shall not return by the same way you came. You have to take another way.
那他为什么会失败呢？
And why did he fail in that?
就刚才说的，因为他没有遵守神的吩咐了。
Because he did not keep and obey this command.
他的失败，他回不了家的原因在这里。
And this is the reason why he could not go home.
其实这个先知哦，他是对神很忠心的。
In fact, this young prophet was a very faithful one to God.
他也有遵守，也有坚持神的这个吩咐，这两件事他都有坚持。
He was one who is faithful in keeping every command and every word of God.
你从第一节开始读的时候，你看到他完成了神的托付，他成功的完成了神托付他的使命，他成功了。
From verse 1 onwards, you can see that this young prophet was always successful in keeping every command of God.
他讲的话也有权柄，也有神同在，也有神迹奇事。
And the words that he uttered came with authority and the miracles of God.
那到这个第七节，那个王对他说：“哈，你跟我回去吧，到王宫里面去吃饭吧。”
Now, in verse 7, the king told the man of God, "Come here with me and refresh yourself, and I will give you a reward."
不单只吃饭，我还要给你很多的奖赏。你想要什么？王宫里面的奖赏，我都可以给你啊。
Not only can you enjoy a sumptuous food, I will also give you any reward that you want.
第八节更厉害，那个试探更厉害，就是把王宫一半给你啊，我都会给你啊。王宫的一半，你开玩笑呀？
And verse 8 lies an even greater temptation that I will be willing to give you half of my palace.
这是王自己亲自承诺的，亲。
This is spoken by the king himself.
这个是个很大的试探来的。
This was a huge temptation.
我都做完工了啊。
I have already done my part.
现在又不是我自己要留下来吃饭。
I was not the one who wanted to stay here.
是王叫我吃饭，不是我要在那边吃饭。
And it was the request from the king that I should dwell here and eat.
应该神分得清楚嘛？我要求要在那边吃饭，还是人家请我去吃饭？那不一样的呀。
And I did not initiate this. I did not ask for it, but the king offered.
如果是我们，我们就有这么多的解释，这么多的理由了。
If that was us, and wouldn't we have so many excuses to explain our way?
可是他怎么回答王呢？
Then why did he answer the king?
第八节说：“我也不同你进去，也不在这个地方吃饭喝水。”
that he will not dine with you, eat with you, or drink water in this place.
第十节说，于是神人从别的路回去了，他两个神的诫命，两个吩咐他都做到了。
And verse 10 it says that he went another way to return home, and indeed he did not disobey the command of God.
请问他有没有坚持神的话呢？
And let me ask you, didn't he obey the word of God?
有啊，很清楚呀。
Yes, he did. Very clearly.
他胜过第一次的试探。
He overcame the first temptation.
而且这个试探不是开玩笑，是王宫里面的试探，荣华富贵的试探来的。
And this temptation was not a small one. It was a temptation of the glory and the splendor of the
palace. 有多少个人可以受得起这种荣华富贵的试探啊？我问你啊。
How many of us can withstand this temptation of wealth and great money and luxury and splendor?
不要说荣华富贵，叫你来守安息日祭坛会，你这么困难啊，你都很难拒绝呀、啊，拒绝世界的引诱呀、啊。
Not to mention luxury and great splendor of this world, even asking you to just give up a little bit of time to come to church, you wouldn't be able to.
第二次试探又临到。
And second temptation came.
第二次是在内部的试探，好，内部里面神国里面的试探。
This second temptation came from within the kingdom of God.
而只是用先知、用老先知、老工人。有经验的工人来试探他，来骗他。
This temptation came from this old and tenured, very senior prophet to tempt him.
那就是在这个十七、十八节啊。
In verse 17 to 18.
哦，那个老先知叫他说回啊，十六节，老先知叫他回去吃饭的时候，他说不可以。
Verse 16, the old prophet said that you shall not come back to eat and drink.
因为神吩咐我说不可以吃饭，不可以喝水。
Because God has commanded that I shall not eat and drink with you.
也不可以从沿路回去。
And I shall not return with you.
请注意，他面对第二次试探的时候呢，他拒绝了。他清清楚楚的拒绝了。
And take note that he rejected the second temptation.
你说他有没有坚持呢？
Can you say that he persist?
他有坚持呀。
He did persist.
所以他又胜过了第二次的试探。
And therefore he overcame the second temptation.
这个是我们要非常清楚的。
We have to be clear with this.
他失败在第三次的试探。
But he failed at a third temptation.
第三次是灵界的问题了。
The third temptation was a spiritual issue.
为什么这样讲呢？
Why am I saying that?
你看十八节。
Verse 18.
请念。
Verse 18, he said to him that I too am a prophet as you are, and an angel spoke to me by the word of the Lord, saying, bring him back with you to your house that he may eat and drink water. He was lying to him.
老先知用他传道人的身份，用他神仆人的身份，不要以为只有你是神的仆人哦，我也是，你知道吗？你不要开玩笑呀。你以为你只有你是先知啊？我也是先知，我做先知比你更久呀。
The old prophet actually used his status as the senior prophet, the older and more experienced prophet, to tempt him.
你不要看这句话这么简单啊！这句话我们在真耶稣教会里面，我们很难拒绝呀、啊。我们在开会的时候，有长老知识比我们更年长的讲这些话的时候，我们很难去反驳他呀、啊。哎，只有你一个年轻的传道这么厉害咩？只有你知道这件事咩？人家其他的长老知识，他们都同意了的呀。人家也是传道，人家也是长老呀，你算什么呀？我们常常因为这样，我们不敢再讲话，因为这些老先知在讲话，我们不敢再提出反对啊，对不对
？Don't even look lightly on this situation. And now that we have also got this situation happening today in our church, where the older ministers and preachers and deacons might be talking, and you do not dare to voice out, even though there are disagreements.
如果是平信徒这样讲，我们可以不理他呀。可是同辈的呀，同一个身份职分被案例的，那就很困难了。非常困难了。
And it would be easier if it was just ordinary church members. But if there were your peers and they are also the same position as you, it would be difficult.
跟做这样不够，拿抬他的身份出来还不够，还抬出灵界的意象出来。
And he took out his position as the prophet. He also took out the vision that he saw spiritually.
不要以为只有你有意象哦，有神给你启示哦。我也有天子奉承的命来跟我讲话呀，我也有意象的。也有神差派天使来对我启示的呀。
He was trying to say that you are not the only prophet here who has got visions from God. I also have visions from the angels and God.
当动用到这种异象的时候，那就进入到灵界的试探里去了。
When he had to put on the table all these spiritual visions, this is a spiritual challenge.
结果他就失败在这第三次的试探。当他提出他是老先知老身份的时候，再提出我有天使有异象的时候，他完全失败。
And because of this, a third temptation, since he was putting on the table his status as the old prophet and also the vision that he saw, and this young prophet failed in this temptation.
19节说，于是神人同老先知回去，在他家里吃饭喝水，完了。神说不可以，他现在在那边吃饭喝水了，完了。
And verse 19 said that this young prophet went back with him, ate bread in his house, and drank water, and he was doomed.
这是一个灵界的问题。
This was a spiritual challenge.
特别是我们神的工人、传道、长老、执事在教会侍奉的传道工人，我们要特别留意这件事。
Most especially to the ministers, the preachers, and deacons of the church, you have to especially examine on this.
撒旦会利用一些工人啊，来欺骗我们，来试探我们，让我们跌倒的，让我们不能够坚持神的话语。就是让同工，让同工害同工啊。
Satan will utilize your peers and your fellow co-workers to lead you into temptation where your co-workers will be causing your downfall.
请注意这件事啊，这事情是发生在神的家里啊。这个旧约圣经的不是在神的家里吗？不是神的工人吗？
We notice that this was in the context of the household of God, the kingdom of God, and this will take place in the house of God.
工人害工人，只有在旧约吗？在新约没有吗？在现在的教会没有吗？
And don't we also have co-workers? We had co-workers hurting each other in the Old Testament. Don't we also have the same case?
那我们来总结一下。
Let's summarize.
这个年轻先知啊，他失败在没有坚持到底神的话。
This young prophet failed in the fact that he did not persist until the very end.
刚才传道说他有坚持，没有错，他有坚持两次，可是他没有坚持到第三次。
And I did say that he did persevere in the previous two temptations, and yes, he did, but he did not continue to persevere in the third time.
你只是坚持一次、两次，你只是坚持那一下子而已，然后再接下去你没有坚持了，你就 OK 了，你就放松了。人家讲两句，人家给一个意向，你就没有坚持了。你应该坚持下去啊！神说不可以啊，神很清楚说不可以啊。我管到你意向从哪里来，我管到你是谁讲的。神告诉我说不可以就不可以，因为我很清楚呀。
Now that you have already persevered the first and the second time, and all you should do is to persevere until the very end. And now that you are so easily giving in, just because of the third temptation where someone claims that he has a vision, and someone claims to be your same position as you, and you already gave in.
今天充满着这个假先知、假工人的这个时代里面。
In this age where we are bombarded with false prophets and false teachings.
所谓假工人就是对神不忠心，对真理不忠心的。
False workers are those who are not faithful to the word of God.
可是这些人是非常厉害、非常狡猾的，非常会做表面功夫的。请大家注意一下。
But take note that these are the people who are the most crafty, cunning, and very impressive superficially.
许多是穿着天使的衣服的魔鬼，他穿着天使的衣服啊，那个魔鬼穿着天使的衣服啊，结果他不是天使来的。
And these are also the demons arrayed in the white robes of the angels.
这个保罗也有提醒我们嘛，他们会穿着光明的天使，你要小心啊，他是骗你，要吞吃你的呀。
Didn't Paul also remind us that they will be disguised in as the radiant and beautiful angels to devour you?
所以我们今天对神的话要绝对绝对的清楚，甚至是很肯定，不单只清楚，而且很肯定的。真耶稣教会就是唯一得救的教会，很清楚的，而且我很肯定的，没有说啊，是咩啊？
Therefore,
真的呀，是这样呀，非常清楚，非常肯定。
You have to build a very strong fundamental clarity with the doctrine, with the truth of the gospel of the true Jesus Church, and not to linger in, not to be doubting, not to be suspecting anymore.
不要听一些人说了什么，说了几句话，讲了一些事情，我们就怀疑了，我们的心就摇动了。
Just because of certain words uttered by some people, your heart is already shaking and wobbling.
好像那个年轻先知啊，他坚持一次两次，他绝对的坚持，绝对的肯定啊。但是他没有坚持到底啊，没有三次、四次、五次下去啊，他没有坚持下去，他坚持一次、两次而已啊。
And just like this young prophet, he persisted the first time and the second time with so much certainty, but he did not persevere until the very end.
如果分不清是神的话还是鬼的话，到时候啊，你真的回不了家的，回不了家的。
If you are one who cannot discern between the words of God and the words of the devil, you are unable to return home.
神跟他讲的才是真正哦，神的话。这个老先知跟他讲的，那是鬼的话，不是神的话来的。
And the words spoken by God to him, the young prophet, was the words of God. And now the words spoken by this old prophet was the words from the devil.
所以我们看希伯来书三章十三节。
We look at Hebrews chapter 3, verse 13.
这里说什么呢？
What does it say here?
这里说呢，我们若将起初确实的信心，很确实的，很肯定的，很清楚的信心，坚持到底啊，不是坚持一次两次，是坚持到最后呀。
If you are able to persist and persevere until the very end with your initial faith, and not only just for a while,
就在基督里有份了，那个天国永远的福分了。
Then you will have a part in Christ, with particles of Christ until the very end.
这一段哦，让我们看到这个工人做完工了，他要回家，却回不了家，在半路就死掉了。
And this is the story, the passage that we want to share about a man or young worker who wants to go home but unable to, even though he wanted to.
我现在做一个见证。
Allow me to testify.
想要回家，回不了家。
About someone who wanted to go home but could not.
有一个弟兄哦，病得很严重，家人在他病床上替他祷告。
There was a brother who was severely sick, and the family members were around his sick bed.
祷告了很久，结果发现到好像断了气了，因为没有呼吸了。
And after some time of praying for him, and they realized that he stopped breathing.
所以太太跟孩子们更多去祷告，主啊，让他回来啊，主耶稣，求你让他复活啊，主啊，不要带走他呀，主耶稣啊，一直迫切的祷告，流泪大声祷告。
And the wife and his kids were praying all the more earnestly, shouting aloud, "Oh Lord, please save him, please heal him."
结果他真的回来了，复活呢。
And true enough, he came back to life.
在祷告中，他们祷告痛苦中，他活过来起，他这样坐起来啊。
In desperate cries and tears, they prayed, and he came back to life and sat up.
哇，他的孩子，他的太太很感谢神，神听我们的祷告啊，神怜悯我们啊。
And he and his wife and his kids were very thankful to God, and they thank God for His mercy.
这个丈夫哦，这个死者哦，这个丈夫他说，不是神听你们的祷告啦，是我回不了家，我要回去，我要进天国，进不了，我进不了，天主叫我回来。
And now this husband who came back to life, surprisingly, said these words that it is not God who have hearkened to your prayers, but it's because I could not enter home. I have to come back.
原来在他断气的那段时间哦，他的灵魂到天上去了。
The time when he lost his breath, he died and he went. His soul was lifted to heaven.
天那么有个很美丽的城啊，天城非常大，非常美丽。
And he saw a spectacular, beautiful, city of heaven.
那有一些人要进天城的人呢，都要排队，有天使在掌门，然后天使在点名的。
And he saw
一个点名的。
There were people, standing in a queue, lining up to be taken names by the angels before entering.
所以你如果有留意哦，在奉主耶稣圣名开始聚会的时候，传道有问候主所亲爱的、所疼爱的，将来要被天使点名的，有没有
？Remember,
点名有名字才可以进去的呀。
Do you remember my greeting just now when I started the sermon by saying that whose names will be recorded by the angels? I said that to refer to this story.
那么点了名过后呢，要进去的人呢？在门那边有一个很大的镜子，每一个人都要向那个镜子照一照，然后才可以进去。
He saw that after the people were being taken names by the angels, they had to come to face a mirror before they were to enter into the city of heaven.
有一些人可以进去，有一些人不能进去。
Then he saw that some people managed to enter, but some could not.
他不知道什么原因。
He could not understand why.
为什么大家都向镜子照一照呢？
Why do they have to face themselves in the mirror?
轮到他的时候呢，天使也叫他去镜子那边照一照。
When it was his turn, the angel also instructed him to face himself in the mirror.
一照呢，他身上那几个黑点、污点跑出来了。
When he saw himself in the mirror, he saw some spots and black marks on his body.
肉眼看不到的，你照那个镜子就照出来。那个镜子，天国镜子，把你的污点照出来。
Those were the speckles and spots that you cannot see with your naked eyes, but the mirror of heaven could show that.
那天使指给他看，你这个污点。
And the angel pointed at him. This was the
天使一指那个污点的时候，他这个弟兄自动知道这个污点是什么，他做了什么错事，犯了什么罪，他自己自动知道。
The moment when the angel pointed a finger on his black spot on himself, he knew immediately what wrong did he do.
天使在指另外一个污点的时候，他也突然间知道，哎，这个是什么事情，他做过什么事，他知道。
The angel then pointed to another black spot on him, and he also knew what he did wrong.
那天使就讲话了。
The angel spoke.
你身上有污点，不干净，你回家去洗衣服，回去洗衣服。
There are black spots on you. You are unclean. You ought to go back to wash your robe.
洗干净再回来。
wash your robe until it is clean before you come back.
听清楚哦。
Listen to this.
你的衣服有污点。
You have dark spots on your robe.
回去洗衣服。
Go back and wash.
洗干净才回来。
Before you come back home.
所以他就这样回来了。
Then he had to come back on his sick bed.
我原来是要回家，回天国啊，回天家，我回不了啊，我进不了呀。
Turned out that he was on his way back to his heavenly home, but he could not enter.
不是主耶稣怜悯，听你们祷告啊，是我没有资格进去啊，我肮脏，我污秽啊，我没有圣洁，我回不了家呀。
It is not that the Lord Jesus is answering your prayer, but it's because I cannot manage to enter home. I have to come back here.
但是神给我们机会啊，给我们恩典啊，你洗衣服就好啊，洗干净就可以回去了。
But isn't this a grace and an opportunity given by God, and you ought to just wash your robe before going?
这个就是要回家却回不了家的一个圣经例子，还有一个天国见证。
This was a biblical story and also a testimony of going back to his heavenly home that I shared about.
好，我们还有一点时间，我们讲第三个回家。
Let me take some time to share about the third message of going home.
第三个回家就是死都要回家。
The third message about going home is that I ought to go home even in death.
到底是谁啊？死了都要还要回家。
Who wants to go home even in death?
那死的他怎么回家呀？
And after he died, how can he go home?
请看创世纪的五十章。
Return to Genesis chapter 50.
创世纪五十章二十四节到二十六节。
Genesis 50 verse 24 to 26.
请念。
24, and Joseph said to his brethren, I am dying, but God will surely visit you and bring you out of this land to the land of which He swore to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, verse 25. Then Joseph took an oath from the children of Israel, saying, God will surely visit you, and you shall carry my bones from here.
看到吗？夜色，我们看到夜色，他死都要回家，看到吗？
And here, can't you see that Joseph even wanted to go home, even after he died?
这是一个很重要的启示。
This is a very important revelation.
是一个很重要的道理。
A very important message.
是一个要临死前很重要的叮咛，最后的叮咛。
His final instruction, his final words before he died.
就是死也要回家。
That he wants to go home even in death.
所以他交代他的兄弟们说，我要死了。神会看顾你们，你不用担心。可是呢，我死过后呢，你们要把我的骸骨带回去，带回迦南地去。
His final plea with his brethren is that I'm dying, but don't worry, God will surely bring you out of this land, but you ought to also bring my bones with you.
他这样的交代告诉我们什么呢？
What is his instruction telling us?
告诉我们夜色的信仰。
It talks about the faith of Joseph.
告诉我们夜色的信心。
The faith of Joseph.
告诉我们夜色的盼望。
And the hope of Joseph.
他虽然在埃及做过宰相，荣华富贵，可是他知道这里不是我的家，埃及不是我的家来的。
He was once endowed in Egypt as a prime minister, and he enjoyed splendor and luxury, but he knew very well that it was not his home.
兄弟啊，知道吗？你在这里再成功，再赚更多钱，再有多少成功成就，多少博士学位。这里也不是我们的家，知道吗？不是你的家来的。
Brothers and sisters, don't you realize that although you are so successful in your life here on earth, this is still not your home.
我们不过是在这里做个过客、过路的客人，在这里只是暂时的居住，在埃及暂时的居住。
What you are to do here in Egypt is only a passerby. You are going to stay here just for a little while.
这个就是约瑟他要表达的，他要坚持的。这里不是我的家，兄弟啊。这埃及不是我们的家来的。
This is what Joseph is trying to express to all of you that this is not our home, brothers and sisters.
那第二个要表达的就是说，我们的家在哪里？这里埃及不是我们的家，那我们的家在哪里
？Now that Egypt is not my home, and where is my home?
约瑟来见证说，我们的家在迦南地。
Joseph testified that our home is in the land of Canaan.
这个迦南地就是神启示应许给我们的应许之地来的。
The land of Canaan is the land of promise revealed by our God.
我死后呢，你们要把我的骸骨从这里搬上去，我要回家，回迦南地去，回神的应许之地。
After I die, you shall carry up my bones from here to from Egypt to the land of promise, to the land of Canaan.
虽然很简单的记录几三节圣经
，Although this is such a brief record in this few verses,
可是他要启示出来的， 他要带出来的信息，带出来的真理是什么呢？
But the message and the revelation from this short record, what is it?
所以约瑟真的是个荣耀神的信徒。
And indeed, Joseph is a believer of God who glorifies God.
纵使在埃及做了有了荣华富贵这么大的权柄，也没有在这个权柄、荣耀、富贵当中来迷失他自己，来丢弃他的神，没有。
Regardless of all these tempting pleasures and splendor that he had as a prime minister of Egypt, he was not swallowed up by all this splendor.
他心里非常的清楚，这里不是我们的家，也不是神允许的地方来的。
It was very clear in himself that he knew this was not his home, this was not a promised land.
我们的家在迦南地。
Our home is in the land of Canaan.
当然，今天的迦南地就是天国属灵的迦南地，那就是神允许要我们回去的天国。
The land of Canaan today to us is the eternal heavenly home that God has promised to us.
这一段圣经就是在告诉我们，死都要回家，死都要回家，坚持要回家。我走不了，你们带我回去，你们把我的骸骨带回去。
This Bible passage tells us that even in death we want to be able to return home, and even if I bite the dust without going home, you have to bring my bones along with you.
约瑟有这样的信心。
Joseph had this faith.
我们也有这样的信心。
And the same for us today.
哦，我死过后呢，我的神会把我带回去，神会差天使把我带回去，天使会带我回去。我有这样的信心，我们有这样的盼望。
We have this faith. We have this hope that after we kick the bucket, and our Lord God will bring us home.
所以在肉体上怎样安排，怎样葬礼，怎样处理我们的尸体，那个不重要的啦，那个无所谓的啦。重要的是把我带回去，我要回去。
In terms of how they will manage my body and how they will deal with my body left on earth, it doesn't matter, because the more important thing is that my soul has been taken back to my heavenly home.
这种信徒很多啊，很多，从旧约到新约都很多呀。
We have a lot of such believers and such saints from the Old Testament to the New Testament.
到今天我们真耶稣教会里面有很多信徒是存着这样的心、这样的盼望回去的呀。
And today in the True Jesus Church, we cling on to this hope to return home.
这叫做死都要回家的呀。
This is what it means by going home even in death.
请看希伯来书十一章。
Return to Hebrews chapter 11.
十三节。
Verse 13.
希伯来书十一章十三节。
Hebrews chapter 11, verse 13.
这些人都是存着信心死的呀。
These are the people who died in faith.
讲这样话的人呢，因为他们明白承认自己在世上不过是客旅，是暂时居住的，他们非常清楚。
These people who utter these words are those who understand very well that they are only sojourners in this world, only strangers.
十五节说，如果他们想念所离开的家，地上的家，他们可以回自己的家，自己的这个世界的家呀。
Verse 15 tells us that if they were to desire for their home, and they have the opportunity to return.
十六节说，他们却羡慕一个更美的家乡。
Verse 16 tells us, and yet they desire even a better,
就是在天上的
a better home, that is a heavenly home.
约瑟最后交代的，最后盼望的，最后想念的，就是这个更美的家。
The final plea or the final instruction from Joseph before he died was for this a beautiful and more and a better heavenly home.
因为他相信神已经给他预备了，给我们预备了一座城，天国城。
Because he believed and he knew that God has prepared a heavenly city for them.
亲爱的兄弟姐妹
，Dear brothers and sisters,
浪子已经成功的回家了。
The prodigal son managed to return home.
而且这个浪子是一个死而复生的孩子。
And this prodigal son was a son who died previously and now resurrected.
但是也有人回不了家。
But there are also some who did not manage to return.
因为他没有将神的话坚持到底。
Because they did not persist and persevere until the very end in the word of God.
他只坚持一两次而已。
He only persevered once and twice.
那最后我们看到有许多存着信心与盼望的人。
And lastly, we also saw these believers or these people who have faith and hope.
这些人死都要回家。
These are the people who want to even go home, even in death.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
所以圣灵说，圣灵做见证。
Therefore, the Holy Spirit testifies.
这些在主里面死的人有福了。
They who die in the Lord.Are blessed.
天上有声音这样的见证。
There's a voice from heaven that testifies to this.
圣灵也见证说，是的，他们系的世上劳苦，是的，他们是有福的。
And then the Holy Spirit testifies and attests to that yes, they have rested from the labor of this world.
但问题是，你有没有这种心，死都要回家这种心呢
？But the question is, do you have this heart to return home even in death?
我们发现到有不少的信徒是不想回家的呀。
But we notice that there are so many members who do not want to come home.
回家吧。
Go home.
现在就回家。
Now go home.
回来神的家。
Go to the home of God.
唱诗。
Sing a hymn.
434首。
434。
你看，当我们唱这首诗的时候，多么快乐，多么的荣耀，多么的兴奋。
When we sing this hymn, we sing with such joy and excitement. Just over in that glory land.
那就是我们的家。
That is our home.
那就是我们想要回的地方。
That's the place that you want to return to.
而且是死都要回去的，就是这个地方。
That's the place that you want to return to, even in death.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
主耶稣保守我们，直到那一天。
May the Lord preserve all of us until that day.
不要成了想回家回不到家那个见证。
And do not allow us to become the person who want to go home but could not.
把衣服洗干净吧。
Wash your robe.
洗干净了再回来。
Wash your robes before you can return home.
来，我们来祷告。
Let's now pray.
把那个荧幕上的这些病者祷告，特别是这些都是那个病毒的 COVID-19 的。
Let's also pray for our brothers and sisters on the list on the screen, especially those affected by the COVID-19.
但愿经过这样的考验，这样死荫的幽谷，这样的熬炼，我们觉悟，神才是永恒，神的家才是平安。
Our hope is that all of us are going through this valley of death. We are able to truly experience the peace of God in us.
紧紧地抓住神。
We seize hold tightly on God.
不要好了，又来去世界滚，又来去忘记神。
don't even want to, after recovering, you go back to love the world.
老师说这样就没有什么意思了。
There's no meaning in that then.
我要回家。
You have to return home.
我死都要回家。
You want to go home even in death.
来，一起祷告。
Let's pray.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告，哈利路亚！感谢赞美主耶稣，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈
Arrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr
哈利路亚，感谢主耶稣，阿门。就在那荣耀国度里，与天使唱和颂赞主，唱哈利路亚赞美主。就在那荣耀国度里，永远在天家享福气，就在那荣耀国度里，就在那荣耀国度里，与天使唱和颂赞主，唱哈利路亚赞美主。就在那荣耀国度里，永远在天家享福气，就在那荣耀国度里。阿门。感谢主耶稣，阿门。感谢主祝福带领我们安息日的机会。
Thank the Lord Jesus for His blessing and His guidance in our Sabbath worship.
聚会到这里结束。
Our service ends here.
那俄麦跟苏棒教会信徒，记得明天早上与主耶稣相约在美丽的祷告花园。
Gombak and Subang Church members, please be reminded to meet the Lord Jesus Christ in a beautiful garden of prayer tomorrow morning.
再见。
Goodbye.